The idea of the presentation, it was built with one of our industrial data scientists, who is a Spanish guy trained in process engineering first, and then having a continuation training in advanced analytics. So we did the presentation together to be sure to cover both basic understanding from a more classical engineer as I am and a data scientist as he is. So first of all, and to maybe answer also to the previous question, when we started the digital transformation, first of all, what we have done is a vision. What is our vision for the plant of the future? And if you look at the adjectives that qualifies that vision, it is not only technical. So mainly you see that the changes in the world are going faster and faster. So we need to be more agile, we need to be more flexible, modular, scalable, etc. Secure for infrastructure access and data, cybersecurity, and so on. A focus on people, so simple, transparent, open for learning. Customer oriented, because the plant is there to make products that we have to sell, fitting to customer needs. But of course, all the target we have as a chemical engineer and as a chemistry as a whole is to be sustainable in the future. So we all have as a target a zero environmental impact, zero accident, etc. So circular economy is also there. And of course, in a more technical way, we want everything to be under control. So predictable, reliable. So you see that the vision goes well beyond the purely process engineering and needs a broader understanding of the ecology and the circular economy. And the way we go is to look at the impact that digital can bring, and always a multidimensional impact. So of course, we can improve the asset performance thanks to data analytics, meaning the yield of the reactions, using less raw material, consuming less energy, but also how to use better the asset network. A number of sites could be used, what's the best way to serve one client, and all the, I would say, scheduling or dynamic optimization algorithms are there. Once you have those assets, you have to maintain them. So how can we be better in predicting what to do before there is any problem and any, downturn? And people are in the center of what we look at, and the digital workforce, so we call it digital way of working. What has changed for them? How to give them the right information at the right time? And finally, we have lots of new technologies that we could incorporate in our sites. Robotics, cobotics, we are testing exoskeletons, we are using drones, we use 3D printing. Then all those things can improve not only the cash generated by the site, but it also helps in having the right product going to the client, quality, benefit, working condition, and safety. So this is what we have in mind when we start a digital transformation. And again, it's not only technical system. So it's not enough to bring a new software on a machine learning system. You need always to measure what you do. So performance management is key. And both of them rely on the mindset and behavior. If you give an operator a new tool, but you don't train him on how to use it, he won't use it for a long time. He could go back to manual mode eventually. So working on the three pillars, technical system, performance management, mindset, and behavior. And again, you will see, going back to Eric's presentation, that you have to work not only on technical courses, also on behaviors, intelligent, IQ, etc. And so if you look at the role of a process engineer for us, the three components most of the time that people present. On the left, for digital, you have all the IT and computer science. On the right, you have the new analytical technology with machine learning, artificial intelligence, etc. And in between, you have those guys called the data scientists, These are new roles coming from a number of years. But both are there to serve a purpose. So there is a domain expertise, could be business, it could be on our side, these are the plant. And you need someone understanding what's going on in that process or that site. And that's the process engineer. You could have other guys there, like a control engineer or scientist. And we have defined intermediate role. Between IT and domain expertise, we locate our data steward or data engineer. And between process and analytics, we have a new role called data translator. We call it also sometimes the digital process engineer. And looking on the right-hand side of the presentation, you see that, in fact, the process is at the basis, of course, of everything. If you run continuous batch or something like this, you have to understand what's going on there. But on top of process, you need a minimum understanding of what are the measures on the process, so actuators, sensors. You need to understand how to control that one, process control. How you can go back to the history data, make correlation, trends, and everything. And then, of course, link that to enterprise or source planification. So you see that industrial data analytics is something on the top of the pyramid, but the global industrial operation covers everything starting from the bottom. So the process engineer is a good position to start and to be able to discuss with the others. So again, going back to Eric's presentation, being able to collaborate in multidisciplinary team and have the mindset to do it is key for further work. So a reference to the article of Dow. So there were discussion in the company also, should we recruit data scientists and train them to learn how to make our products, how to make soda ash, or how to make specialty polymers or vanillin? Or should we do the opposite? Train our process engineers to learn what data science is. And by testing a few data scientists and learning them chemistry, we found it much more difficult than to do the opposite. So we fully agree with this approach of Dow Chemical. And now what we are doing is really going to train process engineers and complete their basic background to fit to digital. And to go that way, what we have done is an exercise by asking experts of all the disciplines that you have seen, process control, etc., two simple questions. Please shortlist the most common problems that you face during a diagnostic on the site. There is a problem that needs to be improved. What are the questions that you raise? And second thing, what are the first software or procedure checklist that you use to solve those problems? Then we classified all what we learned. And you see on the right, we have on the bottom the process. Then we have the instrumentation. We have the control, and then we have something new on top, which is the data. And data, how to analyze data, how to capture data, how to screen data is something that is new for them. And then you see the analytics, which is how to apply more advanced reasoning algorithms than simple regression, is again something new. So what we have done is to build a catalog of training with those three levels. The basic one being awareness and, of course, problem-based learnings. And once these catalogs are available, we go through the process engineers that we have in our GBUs and our site. And depending on their background, we identify the training that they should follow to at least come to the level one, which is being able to understand what's going on there. And making more advanced analysis than the simple Excel regression that they used to in the past. And we continue that with coaching. Once they have done something, it's a coach that continues to work with them. So this is really to answer the question, the way we see how to upskill process engineers so that they are able to take a real key position in the site, in the plant of the future. So as a summary for us, chemical engineering must be taught at university and no one else can do it because it's too complex, it needs lots of things, and it's not at industrial to make that job. Problem-based learning is encouraged. You have seen all the arguments presented by Eric because it's the only way to capture more than 60-70% of what is being explained. Collaboration in multidisciplinary team is key, but to be able to collaborate, you need a minimum understanding of the other disciplines. Otherwise, you can't talk with them. You need there all the soft skills and transferable skills, and I won't repeat what Eric presented beforehand. The question of mindset, it's very important that people have to understand that when they start their career, they come out of university, but they have to understand that the whole career will be a continuous improvement learning. There is always something new. Now we are discussing of digital, maybe in 10 years, something else will come. They should be eager to always learn something new. For us, digital means data, and probably there is something lacking there. The minimum understanding of the importance of data, how to be able to explore, detect, and classify problems using these new process data analytics techniques. And that would allow them to discuss with the data scientist and with the data steward. No, we don't want them to become experts like data scientists. What we have found is that 80% of the problem needs to be understood by advanced analytics. But once you identify the problem, in many cases, it's quite simple to solve it. You don't need to put artificial intelligence in place. But if it is the case, then you must be able to explain this and work with data scientists to put the model in optimization level. And at the end, also, you have to learn by doing. But what is important is to have also this coaching possibility that will help you to move on and to always learn the next step and guide you through your learning. This is what I wanted to share with you. And now, if you have any questions.